So, a lot of you have been asking me like why I disappeared, and guys, I just had my exam phase, finished it like last week, and I'm now back, and I promise I'm gonna make some videos, at least like I hope one a week. Anyway, a lot of you asked me in the comments to talk about the most frequent engineering questions, so, you know, ranging from do engineer make money all the way up to differences between aerospace engineering and mechanical engineering. And I must tell you, that was like the most frequent question. So in today's video, we're gonna talk specifically about that, but also about some of the most asked questions about engineering in general. So I'd say let's begin with the most frequent asked questions about engineering, and then let's turn and go with the differences between mechanical engineering and aerospace engineering, which I'm gonna spoil it to you, they are not that much. So also make sure to watch the video till the end, because there's going to be a surprise and it's a giveaway, so I'm telling you now, but please watch the video till the end. It really supports me. If you haven't already, like and subscribe, it really helps me. And yeah, that's it. Sorry if it's noisy, but I'm transferring to another campus and I'm freaking late for classes, so that's it. Anyway, do engineers use math? Yeah, we definitely do, and we also use a lot of math. We have, I think, 4 exams for classes just about pure mathematics, being calculus 1, calculus 3, calculus 2, I think calculus 3 as well, and numerical calculus with MATLAB and stuff like that. So like the computer aided calculus, which a lot of you might think, oh yeah, that's easier. No, it isn't. And so yeah, we do use a lot of math. That's the fundamental. And I must tell you, at the beginning I was thinking, yeah, maybe it's all overkill, the level of math that we do, and
we're probably going to use computers all the time, so
we don't really need to be that good. But believe me, even just to understand some principles of physics and of flight dynamics, you're gonna need that math or you just won't go anywhere. Probably I'm gonna make a video specifically about all of your questions. So do engineers have free time? I'd say not that much. I mean, depends on who you are and what you wanna do and what you like to do. But generally, at least in my case, I don't. I'm studying a lot, I'm really trying hard to succeed, and if you want to do that, probably you won't have that much of free time, but. With the next question, do engineers make good money? I mean, it really depends on the country you live in, the kind of job you take, and the kind of education you have. Maybe you just did a bachelor, you have a master, maybe a PhD, who knows? But generally, the pay is pretty high, especially in foreign countries. In Italy, it's not that much, so I'm planning to leave. But yeah, generally, we're talking about maybe for the dream jobs, so I'm talking about multinationals, big companies and stuff like that, you're ranging from 100,000 all the way up to 150. So that's good money and really kind of assures you a pretty lifestyle. Do engineers build things? I mean, you tell me. Yeah, that's exactly what we do. And really depends on what kind of engineering you enroll, but generally speaking, yeah, we do.
No.
For the last question, do we need a master? I mean, it really depends on the career you want to pursue. In my case, I will probably apply for a master because I think it's interesting, I think it's useful, and also I really want to specialize on the space sector, so space engineering and stuff like that. I mean, I still like the aeronautical part of it, but at the end of the day, I really want to build rockets or ride rockets, so I mean that's the point. So I think I will do a master, but it's not necessary. Just to make you understand, I'm still in my first semester, actually just started, like it's the third day of the second semester of my university career, and I already had 3 job interviews. So I mean, if you're thinking about do I need it to work and to get a good job, not really. Even just the bachelor is going to be okay. If you want to specialize and if you want to aim bigger, then yeah, probably you will need a master. Okay, I'm now going to my rocketry team. I got a spare hour, so I'm gonna work a little, and yeah, then I'm gonna have like calculus 2 lessons, and just right after that I'm gonna make a video explaining exactly what you should look for when deciding whether to choose mechanical engineering or aerospace engineering. So I've just finished the lessons. If you're undecided between a lot of universities, just go and write down a pro con list with all of these things, I'd say. So the first one is price and availability. So for example, if a university is much cheaper than another one and you cannot afford the other one, yeah, you can do grants. They are pretty rare. You can search and try for scholarships, but again, they're pretty rare, and most of the times they're also really competitive, so you can try different roads, but at the end of the day, the cheaper one is the better one if you cannot afford it. So that's a good one. For example, I got my friend over there who's from like 1,000 and something kilometers from here, and that's a lot. So he has to pay rent and everything. I've been living here for 10 years now or something like that, and of course I have a home here and everything, so I don't have to pay rent, and it's easier, you know. You are studying engineering, you're not studying something else. So try to decide even based on what would be easier, because you want the easier thing because it's already challenging by itself. So don't go out and challenge yourself more than you can do. So the second thing is if you want to do a master. In my case, and what kind of master you want to do. In my case, I really want to apply for a master in space engineering. I'm not sure if I'm going to apply here, probably not. Probably I'm thinking about USA. So if you really want to do a master, let's say in my case, for example, is space engineering. I mean, you can still do it even from mechanical engineering and even from other universities, but like you should try and understand what are the prerequisites of every university. Maybe they value also the maybe they also value prestige of the school. They value maybe the language. So maybe if you're studied in just one language, they won't take you, or they value maybe the GPA. So choosing easier school will make it easier for you to have a high GPA and then subsequently get into that specific master. The third thing is no stereotypes. It's not really something to value. So no stereotypes. A mechanical engineer can work in the aerospace field and vice versa. At the end of the day, you should consider what you're passionate about. If you're more passionate about like general stuff, generic things and everything, mechanical is good. If you are really passionate just about aerospace, like space or avionics, vehicles and everything, you should go and try aerospace. Another thing is project available and internships and if they have a thesis and everything and stuff like that. In my case, I don't have to take a thesis. We have final year projects. But maybe if you're really interested about, let's say, aeronautical engineering, and of course the school that owns an airplane is going to facilitate your work maybe in research, because you can research on that specific airplane. And the same, if you are passionate about like crash tests and crash structures and stuff like that, you're going to take and search for a university that has maybe a crash test stand. In our case, we have a very good wind tunnel. So in my case, I'm really passionate about aerodynamics and stuff like that. So that's a wise choice. So look out for the kind of projects they have, if they have teams, if they have, you know, everything else aside from the academic life and inside the academic life, but you know, like as side projects and stuff like that. Another thing is salary, of course, because at the end of the day, we are starting to feed ourselves and our families in the future. So a school with a general higher starting salary is good. Like, that's a factor you should consider. In Italy, we are the first school in terms of salary. Also, maybe Bocconi, but you got it. So that's another thing to value. And yeah, that's basically it. I think you should just consider these things. It shouldn't be that difficult. Maybe try and come down to less than 10 universities and apply to them all, and choose after you get the rejection or acceptance letter. And that's it. So if you're interested in this kind of videos, if you like this, if you're interested in whatever could come next, I'm gonna make a series about like how to build rockets, airplanes, RC stuff, and everything related to university really, and the aerospace sector, also mechanical sector. So like, if you're interested in this kind of thing, make sure to subscribe. Even if you're not, make sure to like the video, because it really helps me. And if you have any other question, make sure to comment them, because I will answer first thing first. And I'm gonna make a specific video, like a part two of this video, specifically made to help people to understand better like the admission requirements and what factors you should consider to decide your dream school or to decide where to go. And not just that, also at the end of this month, maybe it could be 28 days, could be 33, I'm gonna pick up the three most liked comments, and I'm gonna give away three PCBs of a test stand. Actually, no, yeah, probably it's going to be a launch pad, even better, of my personal launch pad. I did a project, it's literally a TBC rocket with launch pad and ground station. I'm gonna give away three entirely made PCBs for you, and so you can already get and start ahead of all the others. And anyway, I'm gonna teach you how to design, build and buy a PCB like that. So make sure to subscribe and you'll see those videos. And yeah, that's it. There are mighty things. Goodbye.